Welcome back. The White House sent a letter to House Speaker Nancy Pelosi this week suggesting that President Trump is not going to cooperate with the impeachment inquiry, seemingly thumbing his nose at the very notion that the U.S. government was designed with three co-equal branches, specifically to offer checks and balances on each other. When President Obama was in the White House, the Republican-led House of Representatives conducted lots of oversight on the Fast and Furious scandal, on the Benghazi tragedy, and more. We covered it. There were whistleblowers. We covered them. Journalists who covered and citizens who followed Benghazi may find it stunning to see Republican members of Congress trash-talking whistleblowers and inspectors general and trash-talking the oversight responsibilities of the House. Stunning. After all, during the Obama years, in the trenches, pushing to conduct oversight, were many of these same House Republicans, such as then Congressman Mike Pompeo from Kansas.
It's deeply a part of the American tradition and our Constitution that the Congress perform this oversight.
Yes, it is. And Congressman Pompeo fought the good fight and demanded answers.
We now know that the president didn't turn over all the documents in response to a congressional subpoena.
Sure.
And that's just unacceptable.
It is unacceptable. And one wonders what that congressman would make of the Secretary of State, who has the same name, whose department is ordering State Department officials to ignore congressional subpoenas. Likewise, earlier this year, Senate Judiciary Committee Chairman Lindsey Graham told Donald Trump Jr. to ignore a congressional subpoena. A far cry from Graham's views of oversight back when he was in the House presiding over the impeachment of President Bill Clinton.
It is not your job to tell us what we need. It is your job to comply with the things we need to provide oversight over you. The day Richard Nixon failed to answer that subpoena is the day that he was subject to impeachment.
Similarly, during the Clinton impeachment, Rudy Giuliani made it very clear where he stood on the matter of avoiding subpoenas.
All the Watergate litigation resolved the fact that the president is not above the law, is not able to avoid subpoenas.
Now that Giuliani is enmeshed in the Ukraine scandal, however, Giuliani hasn't even made it clear whether or not he is going to honor the congressional subpoena aimed at him. The arguments that Democratic presidents needed to comply with congressional oversight were correct. That's how the system was set up. If you only apply constitutional standards to the other political party and not to your own, then those aren't principles. They're tactics.